Ready? Namaste, everyone, and welcome. Good afternoon. My name is Parvez, and I know some of you. Some of you I don't know so well. And welcome to our session today on Mudras, Health at Your Fingertips. Is that exciting? So many of us spend so much of time with doctors and medication and things like that. And nothing wrong in that, because when we need to, yes, we need to visit them, and they are doing a fantastic job too. But nature has provided us with something as basic and as simple as a body which is beautiful, which works wonderfully, with everything inbuilt. And mudras is a science which was discovered, I would say, thousands of years ago by ancient Indian seers, rishis, sages, who with a lot of practice themselves through intuition, through meditation, learned of various ways in which they could learn to help themselves in terms of healing their body, their mind, energy, everything. So what does mudra mean actually? When I did this, it actually was a mudra also. Did you realize that? So this is a mudra, and we as Indians are very familiar with the Namaste mudra. We call this a Namaste mudra. It is also known as the Atma Anjali mudra in terms of technical terms, but Namaste is good enough, right? So before I go ahead with other mudras, and we have just about an hour left, so I'll be talking about some very basic stuff, very, very basic kind of mudras to begin with. And as you suggested, maybe I can have a follow-up session if the help people want it or ask for it, right? So today we look at some very, very basic aspects of how mudras work, what they are. Mudras essentially means gestures, right? So there are gestures of the face, gestures of the body, gestures of the hands, fingertips. So what I'm going to talk about today are what we call as hasta mudras, that is hand or finger related mudras. So let's begin with a quick practice with just the Namaste mudra first of all. So everyone just do a Namaste if you can. Keep it close to your chest, right? Sit comfortably, close your eyes, and take a few slow deep breaths. And just keep your focus now mentally on the Namaste which you have created, where all the fingertips are touching each other, the palms are touching, and there's a slight hollow in between the two palms. So bring your attention to your Namaste position, and then bring your attention to the rest of your body, to the rest of your mind, to the rest of you, and just observe how you feel while you're doing this. What is the feeling within as you do the Namaste? Just be aware of that. So for the next few seconds, I will keep quiet, and I'd like you to be with this Namaste mudra. Okay, take a nice slow deep breath, slowly open your eyes, and you can come back and you can relax. If you like, you can release the Namaste. Wonderful. So, would somebody like to share the experiences? How did you feel? What did you feel?
Relaxed. At peace.
Yeah, at peace.
At peace. Relaxed. Okay, wonderful. What about you, sir?
Relaxed.
Relaxed.
Very centered.
Very centered. Very balanced. Yes, wonderful.
Yes, very empowering, I think.
Very empowering. Yes. Connecting. Yes. So, the benefits of the Namaste mudra are, like some of you said, it is very relaxing. It is very centering. It balances you. We are putting both our hands together, and through the electromagnetic, let's say the fluid which is within us, the nerves, the electromagnetic substance which flows through our bodies, there's a connection with the two halves of the brains. So when we do this, the right and the left brains are also brought into balance. Otherwise, most of the time, you may be aware, most of us, especially in today's modern urban environment, are using
the left brain.
Oh, okay. Most of us are using only the left side of the brain, right? Which is the logical, the questioning brain, the rational brain, and which is all very well because it serves a great purpose, but somewhere we don't then use enough of the right side of the brain. So the brain which has a fantastic capacity, we end up not using most of it. So the more we do this, we are balancing both the sides of the brain. Apart from that, it calms you, it connects you with the divinity, and it brings in a sense of gratitude, gratefulness, etc., which as you know is a very, very important. Most of us today, many of us who are exploring spirituality, and I think all of us in this room at least are, realize the importance of gratitude. So whether it's Reiki or whether it's Axis or whether it's Brahma Vidya or anywhere else, I keep coming across gratitude as an important way of living in life. And this is something which just brings you in a state of gratitude in a very easy and simple way. And that's what all mudras are. Simple, easy, effective, and quick, often quick. So, how do they work? I'll explain to you in a very, very simple way. We have these five fingers, right? The thumb, the index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and the small baby finger. Each of these stands for a particular element. We have elements all around us. I guess all of us are aware of this. So the thumb stands for?
Earth.
No, the fire element.
Fire.
Okay, what we may call as the Agni, right? The index finger stands for the air, okay? The air element. The middle finger stands for the sky, vacuum, or ether element, right? The vastness of the universe. The ring finger stands for the earth element, the prithvi. And the small finger stands for the water element. That is why on a lighter note, when we want to go to the toilet, we do like that. Do you see where it comes from? Yeah? I don't know whether it's related, but that's quite interesting. So each of these fingers stands for each of these different elements.
One for
water. Okay, so water, earth, the vacuum or the ether, air, and Agni or fire. Right. Now, how mudras operate? Since these elements, in a way, are located, if I may use that term, within each of these fingers, it's the nerve endings which come and end at the tips of the fingers, from which these elements kind of radiate out their particular properties or qualities, including the toes of the feet at the tips of it. Okay, but we are working only with the fingertips where we are working with mudras.
So in the fire.
I guess so. I am not aware of that, honestly, Shobhana. That's a good question. I'll need to find that out. Yeah, but my guess is probably so. Yeah.
Sorry, what is the question?
Just as this stands for fire, this stands for air, do the corresponding toes stand for the same elements?
Okay.
So, I suppose maybe. Yeah. Yeah. Because as you would know, the feet are also points for a lot of acupressure points. So, one has to take care of them, and if you work on the feet also, a lot of things get better. So, when we touch now the thumb with the tips of the different fingers, where each of the fingers stands for a particular element, that particular element gets balanced within you. So when we have illnesses happening in our cells, no problem, please come. Please sit. Oh.
Just
came. Yeah, even I came over 10 minutes ago, 15
seconds. Yes.
Somebody must have kept it
on. Yes. Well, so
thank
you very much for still taking the trouble to come. Five stories
last
up.
Time, last time I had come, but that time it was cancelled. I never knew about it.
Okay.
I came all the way, I sat and then I left. Oh,
okay.
Last time you had decided on Tuesday or something, 1 month back.
There was nobody had turned up. That was okay. We'll talk about that later. Yeah, let me just continue. But, oh, yeah, yeah, okay. Yes. So that's how there were probably two sessions. Yes. Yeah. Okay. So I was talking about each of the elements which each of the fingers stands for. So just to recap for you, We are talking of mudras, which is the finger positions, and each of the fingers stands for a particular element. So come on, now the rest of you, let's recap. Okay, the thumb is for
Agni,
right? Fire. This one,
Vayu
or air, right? This one, ether, sky, vacuum, whatever. The ring finger,
earth,
and
water.
So when we touch each of these fingertips with the thumb tips, these fingers start balancing the particular element in the body. A lot of the illnesses or imbalances in our body, in our life, happen because, as per the ancient Indian Ayurvedic science, these elements are not in balance. Now, this is a very, very briefly and very, very shortly I am speaking about this. There's much more to this in depth. So when there is imbalance in the body, when we just touch these fingertips, the body starts balancing those particular regions. So we'll begin with working with four basic mudras right now and see what each of them does. Okay, so with the thumb, let's first touch the index finger. Okay, index, tip of the index finger. Yes, and you can keep it down like this. And this is known as the Jnana Mudra. Jnana, as most of us know, means knowledge. Okay, so Jnana Mudra is a very powerful mudra, one of the most popular mudras. Many of us have seen pictures of people meditating and they are sitting in this position. You know, the thumbs are in this position. I mean, the thumb and the index finger. So continue to keep your fingers in the Jnana Mudra as I speak about it. So it works a lot on the mind. The air element is connected with the mind matters as far as the Indian medical science goes, and we say whatever imbalances we have with regard to emotional and mental issues is because the air element is not balanced. So when we do the Jnana Mudra, this one, it starts balancing the mental emotional issues in the body. So every time you're feeling upset, stressed, irritable, angry, unhappy, take a few minutes out and sit in the Jnana Mudra. Sit straight as most of you are sitting now. Take a few slow deep breaths, close your eyes and just keep your fingers in the Jnana Mudra position. And just do this for 5 to 10 minutes and you will start relaxing. So what's happening is that all the tension, the stress, the chatter in the mind begins to start getting reduced and dissipated. Apart from this, the Jnana Mudra also helps in enhancing your memory, which is wonderful. So if any of us have children who are studying, ask them to sit in the Jnana Mudra position while studying. Or if you are listening to something new, or you are learning something, or you are watching something and you want to learn, like you mentioned some of those videos on YouTube you want to learn from, just sit quietly with the Jnana Mudra position. It just keeps going straight into your subconscious and starts getting recorded quickly. So Jnana Mudra is a very, very important mudra.
Closing eye and...
Yes, the fingertips.
And concentrating here?
No, you don't need to concentrate here, sir. Then you just, if you're meditating, then you just focus on whatever you're meditating on. So some people meditate on the breath. Some people chant a mantra in their minds. Some people observe the thoughts which are passing through. So on anything. So then you don't have to bring your focus on this. Okay? And if you're reading something which you want to learn, then you don't have to anyway focus, you have to focus on what you're reading. So this then works automatically. Okay? So that's the Jnana Mudra. Yeah, as if you can. If you can keep your fingers straight, please keep them straight.
This touch should be very light.
Very light. You don't have to put any pressure. Yeah. So just keep it as natural as is for you, because different people have different touches. So some people may naturally put pressure on their fingers. Some people have a very light touch. So what is natural to that individual is the best way to do it. So let's just sit for a few moments once again in silence and experience how you feel with the Jnana Mudra. So bring your attention to your breathing. Take a nice slow deep breath. Exhale. Breathe in deeply, exhale completely. almost from a distance observe what's happening within you. So imagine you're observing your own self doing this. A part of you is observing. And remain in the Jnana Mudra and be aware of what is happening within. Are your thoughts reducing? Are you feeling calmer? Feeling more refreshed? More awakened? More light? More clear? Jnana Mudra also promotes clarity of thought and thinking. So whenever you feel confused about anything, and many times we are confused, we can't take certain decisions, do a few moments of Jnana Mudra. 10 minutes to 15 minutes is a good time. A minimum of 10 minutes is suggested. Okay, so slowly open your eyes and come back. How do you feel? What did you all feel? What was the experience? Would you like to share, ma'am?
I felt very calm.
Very calm. Okay.
Some current is going upside.
Okay, so some of you could feel...
feeling weird.
Yeah. So that's because the air and the fire elements are now in touch with each other. And as you see, the fire is stroked by air which contains oxygen. So the electromagnetic currents are moving a little more, maybe stronger than probably they are always doing within. So these currents are all the time flowing within us. Most of the time we are not aware of it, right? Very often it is so feeble we don't realize it. But when we get into this, we realize, as you said, these currents flowing. Okay, so that's the Jnana Mudra, right? What do we use it for? A quick recap.
Meditation.
Okay, one is for meditation. Yeah. What else?
For studying.
For studying. Yeah.
Rather than, I'm not experiencing like parents or anything.
Sure.
The moment I shut my eyes, I got a reflection of
what's happening.
Going on.
Fair enough. So, as I said earlier, this is the mudra for mental and emotional issues. So, if whatever you're reflecting on, there's always a certain mental emotional component. So, maybe that's just come up, and which is maybe like a reminder telling you to look at life a little more closely right now. So, do that. Keep doing that. Yeah. And if this has come up while you're doing the Jnana Mudra and you want to get better, deeper insights into you, maybe it would help you to keep doing the Jnana Mudra and look at what keeps coming up and then work with it whichever way you want to. Okay? So let's move on to the next one. The thumb tip on the middle fingertip, and the other fingers, if you can keep them as straight as you can. Right? This is the Akasha Mudra, sky. The middle finger. Okay, the ether or the Akash Mudra. Now Akash, as we know, is the sky, which stands for vastness, the vacuum, the ether, and all of that. We have a lot of that within the body in terms of the vacuum. So though we think we are a body is compact, there are also empty spaces, which maybe are at a cellular level. So when we do this, we are balancing those elements within the body. The Akash Mudra is very, very good for improving your intuition. Okay, so things like improving your intuition. It's interestingly also works very well for things like toothache, teeth issues, gums. Okay, helps promote calcium in the body, therefore it's also good for bone issues, bones. Okay, so that's the Akash Mudra. I'm saying this in very, very short, right? So intuition, teeth and gum, bones, promotes calcium, and again it gives you a feeling of expansion. So whenever we feel constricted in life, constrained in life, once again where clarity is missing, you can do the Akash Mudra. Right? Remember, this is also for getting clarity because it's the Jnana Mudra, which is the air which clears out the cobwebs. This is once again the Sky Mudra, which brings in clarity. we look at it in connection with the elements once again. And the way to remember some of this is to kind of keep remembering what each finger stands for. That's how I learned. Earlier when I just tried to learn it on my own, what each mudra is, I couldn't. Then I did a couple of classes with some experts. And that's where I realized and understood more deeply the connection between the fingers and the elements. Otherwise, if I just tried to learn ye mudra kya hai, what it works on, it wasn't making much sense. Right? So, next mudra is we move to the ring finger. Do we remember what the ring finger stands for? Which element?
Earth.
Earth element, right? Which we call in our Sanskrit or Indian language as Prithvi. So, let's practice the... Okay, have we done enough of the Akash mudra? We haven't. Okay? Alright, so let's just try it for a few of us. Let's just try the Akash mudra for a few moments. And once again, as I said, keep your eyes closed, relax. Bring your focus on your breathing. And keep your thumb and middle fingertips together. Let's get back slowly. So open your eyes very slowly and come back at your own time. Fine. Would anybody like to share? How did you feel? How did you feel, sir?
I find some sort of similarity in the earlier one.
Sure.
This one.
Okay.
The same thing, during the relaxation. Same little elevated level.
Okay. Because once again, as I said, it's to do with the sky, which is again to do with elevation. But there are also these specific benefits in terms of toothache, calcium, bones, etc., which are, let's say, the additional things which you get from the Akasha Mudra. Right? So if you have children who sometimes complain of toothache, right, you can just tell them to do this till you kind of maybe rush them to the dentist, or sometimes you may not need to take them to the dentist once you have done this for a few minutes. If it's not a very, very major thing, right? Again, it's good for people who have bone issues. You know, as people grow in life, you need to keep taking better care of your bones, and this helps you create calcium quite naturally, which we know is required for the bones. Okay, then we move to the next one, which is the Prithvi Mudra, the earth element. So, the ring fingertips with the thumb, right? So, before I tell you what are the benefits of this, now I'd like you to experience this. So, just create the Prithvi Mudra for a few moments and just sit quietly once again and see what you feel inside you. There are benefits which may not be apparent as of now, right now, which I may need to tell you. But just for the moment, keep your fingers in the Prithvi Mudra position. Let's get back slowly and gently, take your own time. Yes, any sharings? What did you feel?
Very rooted.
Very?
Rooted.
Oh, rooted. Okay.
Grounded.
Grounded. Okay. Anybody else? Shobhana?
I'm just reflecting back.
Okay, fair enough. Right. What about you, sir?
Down to earth.
Okay. So, as the name suggests, it's Prithvi Mudra, which is to do with the earth. And yes, it does make us feel a little more stable. right? The advantages of doing Prithvi Mudra is it helps to bring in more energy and strength, right? Now, whether it brings it from the earth or it just comes through your own body, doesn't matter. It's your getting the most strength through the Prithvi Mudra which is important, right? So whenever you're feeling tired, for example, do the Prithvi Mudra, right? There's another mudra which I'll speak of, which also enhances your strength. But right now we are talking about the Prithvi Mudra. So Prithvi Mudra increases your strength, your physical strength abilities pretty quickly. Apart from that, Prithvi Mudra helps in the production within the body of vitamins A, B, C, D, E and K. Alright, so it's like your own body's own pharmacist. Right. Now, I don't really know what A to K vitamins do. I just believe they do something which is beneficial for us. And that's good enough to know. Right? It's like when you're driving a car, you don't need to know how the engine operates. You just need to drive the car and take a drive. Move into it. So, this mudra helps to create these vitamins. It balances out. Wherever there's a deficiency, it helps to start promoting the creation of vitamins A, B, C, D, E and K. It's very good for the skin. The Prithvi Mudra is a mudra which you do regularly. Helps to bring in youthfulness back once again is what the rishis discovered. Okay? So it brings a radiance on the face when you do it regularly. It helps with hair growth, interestingly. So hair grows better, thicker, prevents hair from graying faster. And according to some people, even gray hair starts turning black. But I haven't yet tried that. I need to do that, I think. Yes. So now, if you really want to try that out, I'm told you need to practice that for 50 minutes a day. Yeah? For the 50. Yeah? 50 minutes a day. Followed by what is known as the Prana Mudra for 15 minutes. I'll come to the Prana Mudra shortly. Okay? So, Prithvi Mudra, therefore, once again, promotes the various vitamins in the body. It's good for bringing strength back. It re-energizes you. As you saw, it makes you stable and balanced. And good for the skin, skin and the hair. Right? Promotes overall radiance in the body, youthfulness in the body. Who wouldn't like that? Mm. Yeah? So, whatever age you are at, you can start right away. Only thing is, keep the practice regular. Many of us who keep exploring, we learn something, we do it for a short time, we stop doing it. Right? So, let's keep doing that a little more determinedly. Next, we come to the mudra, where you touch the small finger with the tip of the tongue. Keep the other finger straight as much as you can. For me, this finger doesn't go very straight. Can't help it. Okay? So, wherever you can, you do this. That's the one. Yes. The baby finger or the pinky finger or the little finger and the thumb. This is the Varuna Mudra because it's the one related to water. Right? So, this helps in terms of all water related issues in the body. Blood is water. And that's what I told you earlier. This would also help in terms of better blood circulation. For those people who have issues with, let's say, very scanty urination or excessive urination. Either way, this helps in balancing it out. Once again, since it balances out the water element, it's also good for skin-related issues because a lot of dryness of skin comes because either one lacks water element or something of that nature. So, this helps in that. This also helps with things like cramps and pains. Sometime back, my daughter had a sudden cramp, you know. And she just quickly ran through my book on mudras. She herself found out which one it is. She did this in a few seconds, the cramps went away. You know? And she's at an age where, you know, all this, she thinks her father's a little nuts doing all this kind of stuff. You know? But at that time, she really wanted to try it. It worked. And now, when she has some issue, she tells me, okay, Dad, what mudra do I try? You know, I just look, here's my book, take a look. Yeah? So, that's how she's getting interested in this. So, yes, these things work and sometimes they work very fast, right? So, some mudras work instantly. Some mudras may take some time to start showing you the effect. Now, these mudras where we touch the thumb with the tips of the fingers are known as the balancing mudras. Okay, wherever we feel there's some disbalance in the body, which is, you know, some illness, some ache, some pain, that's an imbalance in the body. Just start doing these, right? But there are other mudras also, which are also known as therapeutic mudras, which you do specifically for specific issues, right? So I'll just share a couple of them with you right now. We did this, it's not a therapeutic mudra, we did the namaste before you came in. This is also a mudra, and when you do this, the left and right side of your brain gets balanced, your mind gets relaxed, you start looking at things in a much more balanced way, I would say, promotes gratitude, a feeling of goodness, relaxation, connection with the divinity, and so on. So actually, if you see, everywhere you put your fingers and positions in any way, they are all mudras. So even if you're sitting like this, it's some mudra you're working with. Yeah. The good thing is, mudras do not have any side effect. Okay? Most mudras do not have a side effect. So you can use them, work with them, experiment with them, play with them. Right? Now, the mudra which is coming to my head straight away to share with you, because a lot of people these days have hypertension, heart-related issues, and such things, is a mudra called the Apan Vayu Mudra. But before I take you to the Apan Vayu Mudra, I'll share with you two other mudras which are related to that and which are much more simpler. So first we look at the Apan Mudra or Apan Mudra, A-P-A-A-N or A-P-A-N, whichever way you want to spell it, it's Apan. So you look at the middle finger, ring finger, and touch them with the thumbs. Okay? These two fingers touching each other, plus the tip of the thumbs touching this, the Apan Mudra. Apan Mudra is very good for digestion related issues, stomach related issues, stomach pain, and those kind of things. So if you have issues with things like, say, gas in the body, flatulence, releasing air, all of that, plus aches and pains, you can do the Apan Mudra. Right? So it's, and then you do it generally after lunch, or after dinner, or after having eaten anything, after any food, right? So normally you may want to try the Apan Mudra after having eaten anything. So as I said, this is good for any stomach related issues in this part of the body region. Okay? Apan Mudra. Then there is another mudra which is called the Vayu Mudra, where we place, if you remember, the Jnana Mudra was where you were touching the index finger, tip of the index finger with the tip of the thumb. In the Vayu Mudra, you touch the tip of the index finger to the base of the thumb, like this. Okay, this is the Vayu Mudra. Vayu again stands for air. Right? Now, whenever you touch any fingertips to the base of the thumb, okay, like this, what are we doing? We are actually increasing the element of fire. We are giving it air, for example. Right? And when we touch the tip of the thumb to any of the bases of the other fingers, we are increasing those particular elements. If I do this, I am increasing the air element. If I do this, the ether element, earth element, and the water elements. Right? So the Vayu Mudra is where you touch the tip of the index finger to the base of the thumb. This again helps in terms of the digestion related issues, but this is again a very good mudra for things like aches and pains. Okay, so any aches and pains you have, except maybe for a headache for which you can do the Jnana Mudra, this is the one which you can work with. This is very good after things like accidents and all. Helps in quick healing of the body. So this is the Vayu Mudra. Yeah. When I bring my ring finger to the base of the thumb along with the, see, this is the Vayu Mudra, right, where the index finger is touching the base of the thumb. Now when I bring the ring finger also, not the ring finger, sorry, the middle finger, yeah, over here, this becomes the Shunya Vayu. Okay, Shunya Vayu also has similar properties, and this is a very good when you find it difficult to fall asleep. So for people who, sometimes you hear people say, mujhe neend nahi aati hai raat ko, ya kabhi bhi. Yeah, but generally people have this complaint when they are not falling asleep in the night. So do Shunya Vayu about 10-15 minutes before you're going to sleep. and just remain in that position and let it go. So keep it. Yes. Yeah. And if you can, just gently bring the thumb down on it so the fingers remain. That's okay, sir. And then you can just bring the thumb, if you can, on it like this. Like this. See. If possible. Wherever possible. Sometimes, you know, because we have not used our hands much for mudras, our fingers also resist. So sometimes you may get a little bit of discomfort with the fingers. That's okay.
This while index
and middle finger. Index and middle finger. That's the shunya vayu. Only the index finger, that's vayu. Okay?
And this is
shunya vayu. Right? Okay? So this is the one way, if you know somebody who finds it difficult to fall asleep, suggest to them to do the shunya vayu. Right? Now you're in a class, for example, say you're getting bored and you start feeling sleepy. Right? So what do you do? How do you prevent falling asleep? So you do a slightly opposite mudra, which is you touch the index finger, the middle finger to the tips of the thumb. Okay? So if you remember, this is shunya vayu for falling asleep. This is to wake up. So you know, sometimes some of us have difficulties to wake up in the morning, or kids don't want to wake up. So teach them, okay, so the time to get up, please put these three fingers together. Right? This is the Vyana Mudra, V-Y-A-N. To be awake, it creates energy, promotes more energy within you.
Vyan.
Vyan, V-Y-A-N. So this is Gyan, this is Vyan. Yeah? Okay, now we come to another very important mudra, the Prana Mudra, P-R-A-N. Pran, as most of us know, also stands for, the term stands for life. Okay? So the Prana Mudra is when you bring the ring finger and the small finger together and touch the thumb tips. Keep these two fingers straight. Right? Like this. So how many of you remember there used to be a wonderful actor years ago in the Hindi film industry called Pran? Yeah? And Pran used to do very often villain roles with a gun in his hand. So this is the way you need to remember Prana Mudra. Pran the actor with a gun in his hands. Okay? So Prana Mudra, once again, is the mudra for vitality and energy. As I said, like the Prithvi Mudra, this also promotes a lot of energy.
These two or this also?
No, only these two. And these two you keep straight. No, this one will go down, sir. This one you need to bring down. Yes, and this together. Okay? Yeah. Now, one thing which I must tell you is, when you are doing mudras practice, preferably please do on both the hands simultaneously. Unless you can't use one of the hands for whatever reason. That hand could be injured or hurt or whatever. But whenever you're practicing, do both the hands simultaneously. Okay? So the Prana Mudra once again promotes a lot of energy, vitality, strength, etc. in the body. Right? Because it's a combination of the earth and the water along with the fire elements, right? Prana Mudra specifically is also very good for eyes. So Akash Mudra, if you recollect, is for teeth and bones. This is for eyes. And this, if you recollect, is for the Earth Mudra. Which ones are these for, if you remember?
Strength
and skin and hair, right? So similarly, Prana Mudra is for
vitality
and the eyes. Okay? Now,
this vitality comes from where? From universe or?
Yes, from the universe. What happens is, we in a way get in touch with the universe, and that particular element which we need. When we do these mudras, those elements get more activated.
No, but it comes from outside or from within?
From within. Huh? From within. And I am sure in a way we also absorb it from outside. So I guess it's a question of both. You know, I'm not very, very sure about that answer exactly. Where does the vitality come from? One is when you use the mudras, it's a body which creates its own energy, etc. But I think because we are part of the whole universe, and the whole universe is in a way part of us, I'm sure we pick up energy from there. It's like when you do the Prithvi Mudra, you're picking up energy anyway from the earth. So in that way, we are connecting with it. Yeah. So this is good for eyes also. So when you want to improve your eyesight, work with the Prana Mudra. There's a quick little exercise we can do with the prana mudra for the eyes. Do the prana mudra, everyone. Yeah. Then close your eyes. Okay, but wait, don't close your eyes. No, first watch me do it, and then you can do it. Okay. Close your eyes, and with the prana mudra, tips of your fingertips on top of your eyelids and below your eyelids. Do this 11 times. So this is one. When you complete it, see, this is A and B, that becomes one. Then once again, A, B, that's two, A, B, three, right? So when we do this about 11 times, it's supposed to be very good for the eyes. Yes. Okay, so prana mudra, yes. Close the eyes, yes. Yeah. One, two, three. Not on the eyebrows, on the eyelids. Eyelids, not over your ear. Okay? Yeah, so on the closed eyelids. So let's do this 11 times, all of us. No. Yeah. Okay, so when you do this and this, that completes one round. That's one round, and then you have 10 other rounds. So that's how it makes it 11. See, this is round one.
Yeah,
round
that
two.
Huh. The question is that is it supposed to be done like this and this only?
Yes, yes, yes.
Like, if we can do like this and bring it
back. No. Like this. That's the way I have been taught. So that's what I'm sharing with you. Okay, so that's the prana mudra. Now, if you remember, I mentioned earlier about working with hair to make the hair stronger, maybe prevent it from graying. You do the prithvi mudra for 50 minutes, right? Follow that with the prana mudra for another 15 minutes. Okay, so 50 minutes of prithvi followed by 15 minutes of prana for better health of the hair, right? Prithvi. Pehla Prithvi Mudra 50 minute ke liye, right? Uske baad aap Prana Mudra kijiye 10 se 15 minute ke liye. Now if you cannot do 50 minutes of the Prithvi Mudra at a time, you can break it up. So you can break it into say 15, 15, 15, and simultaneously you break up the Prana Mudra into 5, 5, 5, right? So it's like if you're taking a tablet and then you put in water. So the Prana Mudra is like putting the water in. You take the tablet and then you flush in. The water is coming through the prana mudra thing. Okay? Alright. And one final important mudra. I was speaking about people having issues with the heart and cardiovascular issues. We did the Vayu Mudra, if you remember. We did the Apan Mudra. A combination of the two is called Apan Vayu Mudra. Right? So, you do the Vayu Mudra first. Okay? And then, Vayu Mudra where you touch the... Yes? Yeah, base of this, and then these two fingers you touch with the tips of the thumb. The middle finger, ring finger, touch the base of the thumb. Yeah, this is called the Sanjeevani Mridya, the mudra, or Hriday Mudra, or Apan Vayu. So this mudra, I'm told, has actually helped people, you know, survive when they have got heart attacks. They have to be quickly put on this. Then they were rushed into the medical facilities and whatever had to be done, had to be done. The doctor said maybe something happened because of which they were survived. Yeah. So this helps. So doing this regularly for us, doing this regularly prevents any heart related issues or chest related issues. Okay. So this is the Apan Vayu Mudra. So how many mudras have we looked at today? I guess the time is kind of going forward. So let's just take a quick look. We began with the Namaste Mudra. Mm-hmm. Then we did the four balancing mudras, which is this one. Can you remember?
Vayu.
No, this is not Vayu. Gyan.
Gyan mudra.
Yeah, then?
Akash
mudra.
Prithvi.
Varun mudra. Or Jal mudra, right? Okay. Then what else did I share with you? We did the Vayu. We did the Shunya Vayu. Okay, so Shunya Vayus, if you are not falling asleep, Vayus for the aches and pains, etc. Right? Then we did the Apan Vayu. Right? Anything else I've shared in terms of mudras? Prana Mudra. Right? Prana Mudra, which is again a very, very important mudra. And Apan Vayu. Yes. Okay, Apan Vayu, the index finger to the base of the thumb and touch the tips of the thumb to the middle finger and the ring finger, keeping the small finger straight. Got it? This is a very important one for cardiovascular issues. That's why it's called the Sanjeevani Mudra or the Hriday Mudra or Apan Vayu, because it's a combination of Apan and Vayu. Fine? Very quickly, if sometimes you have a ear pain, earache, yeah, you can do the Shunya Mudra, which is the middle finger to the base of the thumb. Shunya Mudra. And I found this also works very well. Shunya Mudra is the mid finger base to the thumb. Okay? Sometimes when you're flying, you know, we have this funny thing in the ears that's very annoying at times. And these days, airlines don't even give you cotton. Earlier, I remember they used to give us cotton. Yeah? I have tried this in aircrafts. When I have this weird feeling in the ears, this is very good. Yeah? Shunya Mudra. Shunya.
So, above the middle finger, we put the thumb.
Yes, like this. So, tip of the middle finger to the tip of the thumb, right? And close the thumb on top. Yeah, so it remains. Shunya Mudra. Shunya circle. Right? Yeah, you could do that. These two, Shunya Vayu. When you do this, this is Shunya Vayu. Right? But when you open this up, it's just Shunya. And this is specifically for the ear issues. This, apart from ear aches, it also helps in terms of operating for preventing deafness. And if there is deafness, it starts reducing deafness, helps promote hearing. Okay? So you can imagine how amazingly powerful these mudras are. Right? This is Surya Mudra. When I bring my ring finger tip to the tip of the thumb. So ring finger tip. Yeah, ring finger. No, this is the middle finger, sir. Ring finger, this one. Yes. Okay, guess what is this helpful for? Again, an issue many people keep struggling with these days. Cholesterol. Okay? So, if you have cholesterol or you want to prevent cholesterol, you know anyone with cholesterol issues, well, they can continue to do whatever the doctor tells them to do. Okay, we are not saying don't listen to doctors. But this is a very good one, Surya Mudra, for handling cholesterol. Okay, and any other water related issues in terms of too much of, you know, water. People sometimes put up a lot of weight because of excessive water. Okay, it's an issue by itself, water retention or something it's called.
Yeah,
then you put, yeah? Okay, so then you place the small finger, tip of the small finger to the tip of the thumb, like this. This is Jal Nashodak Mudra. Jalo Nashodak with Mudra. It's a slightly difficult name for me to say it, but Jal we all know is.
To the tip of the thumb, right?
To the tip of the thumb, yeah.
Right? If he
can. Yes, sir, it will be a little difficult initially. That is why you have to put your thumb, aapka thumb uspe laga dijiye. Haan. Yes. Yeah. Okay? Yes. Try. It will come. Slowly, slowly it will come. Yeah? So this is to handle, once again, water related issues. Water retention ke liye. Yeah? When you are lacking water, when you need to drink more water and sometimes you don't find water or you don't want to drink water because you're not sure of the hygiene element of the water, then you do the Varuna Mudra, where you're balancing the. So this is to reduce the water element. This is to reduce the water element. This is to balance and increase the water element. Okay? Yeah. So that, I think, in short, was about mudras.
Very good.
I hope you all enjoyed it and you found it useful. Thank you once again, and we end once again with the namaste. Thank you. So before we all